This is happening today. It's a wonderful thing.
A local teacher is on a crusade to bring fresh food to her students.
He is not normally a man who does a lot of work around home, but today, are you learning the business end of a shovel?
Well, you know what? A very interesting thing, Chris and Lynette. Hi from Manual Arts High School in off of Vermont in South Central. A little bit of gardening math. Let me show you that orange tree and the base of that tree and try to get that tree into this hole.
We need a bigger hole.
You're
going to
need a bigger hole. So we got kids working away. It's some roots there. Let me just take you through the course of the day here. We'll start with some tape that we ran last hour. This all started with a garden here. A lovely little garden that students have attended to, and the whole notion of food security and doing more than just growing, you know, a few herbs and vegetables. And it has morphed into this, a huge day of tree planting. Push up the second tape and we'll show you a lesson that all these kids and adults received a short while ago, where they learned from fallen fruit how to go about planting trees. So they've been given that instruction of exactly what's required in terms of how much soil you put on top, what you do, how you plant the tree. And after that lesson, here we go, back live, and everybody digging like mad over dozens of trees being planted during the course of the day today. We'll bring back Barry Applebaum, who he described as our crusading teacher. Barry, come in front of the orange tree. And so what's the goal for today? What is happening in the next couple of hours?
Okay, so our goal for today is to plant these 40 fruit trees at school and throughout the community. We have families who are adopting trees and planting them in their front yard, so we have public fruit for everyone.
That is such a terrific idea. So the notion is, of course, fallen fruit helping to provide those trees. Did you reach out to families and say, hey, look, we're in the process of doing this. Do you have some space on your front lawn?
Yeah, so I had my students go home and ask their families if they were interested in not only planting but caring for the fruit trees, and we had some students who have done that, so they're taking trees home with them today.
And the phrases that we have used during the course of the morning here is this notion of food security, having your own, and the idea of an area such as this often being referenced as a food desert, that affordable, fresh, and healthy foods aren't necessarily easily available.
Yeah. So by planting these trees, they're taking the matter into their own hands, and they're providing fruit for their families and for their neighborhood.
Well, it's a remarkable turnout now, only because Chris and Lynette think I'm not adept. I'm actually going to, here, come with me, because I might have you hold the microphone. I'm going to borrow one of these shovels, you guys.
Yeah, Sam's going to get a blister.
Sam is going to shovel.
Okay,
you've been shoveling it for years, Sam.
That's kind of a little shovel. I can do better. Well, that's true. I can do better than that. Here, let me have that big one right there. Can I steal that shovel from you?
They don't want to give up.
They don't want the liability.
All right, Barry, you hold this for a second.
All right,
I'm going to give that back to you.
Let's see
if you really know how to handle a shovel, Sam Rubin.
You put your foot, oh.
Oh, yeah.
Look at that.
Not bad.
He's putting his back into it. Look at that. He's got it. He knows exactly what he's doing. Sam Rubin, you're doing a good thing. You're doing a good deed today in Vermont Square.
He's going to have to get a manicure after this.
The part that Chris was supposed to attend to, and it's not his fault, is this is the part where the big truck from Lowe's or Armstrong or Green Thumb pulls up and they bring a huge amount of gardening tools and other things so they can expand the program here. We didn't get that together for this morning, but I don't see Chris and Lynette why we couldn't do that on another Saturday morning. Wouldn't you agree?
Absolutely.
Absolutely. You're always welcome. We love having you here.
Thank you, Sam. Thank you so much.
Well, not me.
No, you're going to go back and work. They're going to bring the tools and you have to do the work. What are you talking about?
This is great. Sam, thank you so much for sharing this.
Exactly.
I love when Sam gets excited about something, because there's nothing as good as when he's actually excited.
Well, he's
about
excited about kids and doing good things. And you know what? That's pretty
special. Producing food.
We love that.
That too.
We'll be right back.